Just say it.
TCT presents. Go, say go.
I'm just saying.
I am so hype, happy that you're here with me today, man. We are going to have a ball.
I'm just saying with Dan Willis.
Oxford, North Carolina, evangelist Loretta Yancey McNeil is in the house tonight celebrating her new release, Thou Art Worthy, from the community church. And we've been saying it's two circles and a blow. When you feel what she's going to sing here tonight, I promise you, you're going to feel empowered by the Holy Spirit tonight. So we're going to have a great time here hanging out with my girl, evangelist Loretta, tonight. So don't go anywhere. Holler at somebody. Tell them get it on lockdown right here. Wow, you know, it's one thing to get chosen because you were the best at something, but when you think about the fact that I'm just still thinking about that song, that God chose you after seeing the worst in us, but he made you at your best, so he knows what you're capable of doing, and he sees that in you tonight. Hey, speaking of God seeing the best, I got one of the best in America here tonight. I'm really happy to welcome tonight to the show from Oxford. Now, that's a new one for me, Oxford, North Carolina, my friend evangelist, Gloretta, but I like to say it like this, Gloretta.
Yeah.
Can I say it like that?
You can say it like that.
Evangelist Gloretta Yancey McNeil, welcome. Yes. I'm so happy you're here today.
Thank you. I'm so glad to be here. I'm excited.
Oh, no, it's my privilege to have you. We're celebrating your new release, Thou Art Worthy.
Yes.
And I'm really, really thrilled that you're here with me
yes.
tonight. Thank you for coming to have it here on I'm Just Saying.
Yes, I'm just saying. I'm glad to be here.
Tell you what, let's get this party started. You need to give a shout out to your church, your
yes,
family. You better look
yes.
right in that camera and tell somebody. Tell.
Yes.
Give a shout out to whoever you love.
Cornerstone Christian Community Church in Oxford, North Carolina, my pastor Jay Phillip and Teresa Betts. Just want to say thank you for allowing me and sponsoring me to be here, and to my family in Oxford, the Yancey family. God bless you.
Well, there you go. So, you know, people always like that when you give them a shout out.
Yes.
And they watch your television show. I'm
yes,
just saying.
Exactly. I'm just saying.
Listen, you, one thing I found out about you that was very impressive to me, the legendary Caravan Gospel Singers are recording one of your songs.
Yes. My Soul Says Yes off of the CD. They approached us and wanted to do the song. And not
What'd you
only
do when
that,
you got the phone call?
I didn't believe it at first.
Yeah, right.
Yes,
right.
But then when they actually laid the song and then invited us to come and be a part of the background, and you would hear a little bit of my voice on the CD, and it should be out sometime this year.
Well, when they get their Grammy, make sure they give a shout out to I'm Just Saying, because you
okay?
Okay, will you sing it here tonight? Are you going to sing that
yes,
song?
I'm going to sing.
You are.
My Soul Says Yes.
Yay! Tell me a little bit about your start in gospel music. You've been singing since you were a kid?
Yeah, I started, my first solo was at 6 years old.
Oh.
And I started with my family group. And see, I have 10 siblings.
Oh, my Lord. And your mother is still living.
Yes, she
God
is.
God love her. You better give a shout out to Mama.
Mama, God bless you. Mama Yancey.
11 children.
Yes.
So she started you off early.
Yes, and we sang early. It was three groups in the family from the very beginning. And we grew up singing gospel music, loving gospel music. And
there's nothing like it, is there?
Nothing like it. It's the music that goes directly to the soul.
It's soul singing.
Yes, it is.
Oh, yeah. So, you know, whenever I think about somebody who's been singing such a long time, what motivates you to keep on going? I mean, what is it? What's the motivation?
The motivation is when you know God for yourself, when you have that relationship with God for yourself. Because when we started out singing, it was just about the gift.
Yeah.
But then when Christ came into my heart and set me free, and now I sing out of my soul because I love the Lord.
Well, you've been through some stuff to have that kind of soul singing.
Yes.
We only got a couple minutes in this interview because they're going to hear you sing, but tell a little some of the things that you've been through, because sometimes people see you on international television and look how cleaned up you are and nice and everything.
Yeah.
They think, well, she ain't been through nothing.
Yes,
I was reading some of the stuff you've been through.
Yes, I've been through some things and the Lord delivered.
You were diagnosed?
I was diagnosed with sarcoidosis back in the later part of the 80s. And then my husband at the time, after that, was diagnosed with cancer. And then in 1995, the Lord saw fit to take him on home. And I had three kids, and the baby was 6 months at the time. And
so your husband goes home to be with Jesus, and you have a six-month-old baby.
Yeah, and he was only 37, and I was 35 at the time. But the Lord did something during that time, because it was in worship, that the Lord healed my heart. In worship.
So as you sang unto the Lord,
I sang unto the Lord in worship and giving myself to Him.
Wow. Is that the balm in Gilead, you think?
Yes, it's a healing balm.
Yeah.
Because in His presence, is where He takes the hurt.
Yeah.
He takes the hurt.
Yeah.
And I tell people heals this, the heart.
Right. Don't you tell people all the time who say, well, I can't go to church because I don't feel. If they would get to the house of God and
if
get
they
anywhere,
would get there.
Come on, Evangelist Loretta. Tell them.
In the presence of God, where there's fullness of joy, they're going to get the release they need. Because you really don't know the depth of pain. It's a healing that you need. And once you're in the presence of God, He does the work. An unseen work that when you get up, you're free.
Did they come too late to tell you He won't fix it? They came too late to tell you, didn't they?
Came too late.
Because He fixed you.
He did. And I'm so grateful. It's the Jesus who touches our heart and heals us. He's a heart fixer.
Yes, He is. Now, I want to tell people where they can find you. They can go on yanceyfamilyministries.org.
That's correct.
It's right there on your screen. Yancey with an E-Y at the end. yanceyfamilyministries.org. And make sure, this is just a delightful young lady. Her spirit, the presence of God just exudes off of your life.
Thank God.
You're a blessing to have her tonight. Will you sing
so
for us?
Good. Yes, I would love to sing for you.
Thank
you so much.
Make North Carolina proud tonight, okay?
Yes,
you gotta represent.
Yes, I will.
That's how we say it in Chi-Town.
Thank you so much.
So while Evangelist Gloretta Yancey McNeil, I just like saying that, Gloretta, while she's getting ready to sing for you tonight, such a sweet.